Hey, what's up everyone? This is Omar, and in today's video, we'll show you how to balance Xeon Weeble Lab in just 3 minutes. Yeah, you heard it right. I got Sunny A7 III with Xi 16235 F4, and total weight is 1200 grams, 2.6 pounds. Run the clock, and let's get started. So first of all, we'll find the gimbal totally locked straight out of the box, and that's great for packing and traveling. The three locks are on the tilt axis, roll axis, and pan axis. And we're now in the locked for storage status. All the gimbal arms are locked and folded to the minimum size. And to start balancing, unlock the roll axis, which is right back here. Turn the roll axis to the right and lock it up. And then we're now in the locked installation status. I like Xeon how made balancing easier than ever before. We'll feel this right after balancing it the first time. Alright, next up, mount the camera on the quick release plate. Use a coin or something else to turn and lock the plate screw. The bigger your camera and lens setup, the further back you should place your camera on the plate. You're gonna save a lot of time when balancing if you know this in advance. Mount the quick release plate with the camera into the quick release module. Push it all the way back until you hear the click sound. Tighten the screw knob. This backing base is only needed if your lens is bigger or larger than your camera body. So you basically put it right here and it's gonna make the camera the same height as the lens. Don't consider this as an example because I don't have a larger lens. Unlock the tilt axis and the camera locking latch. Push the camera to move forward or backward until it can stay still and almost leveled. Tighten up the camera mounting thumb screw. Make the lens face up and slightly loosen the thumb screw. Push the camera to move forward or backward until the camera can stay with the lens facing up. And tighten the thumb screw. I sometimes find the axis hardly moving, so if you face the same situation, just push the camera a little bit up like you're holding it and then push forward or backward. Next up, unlock the roll axis and slightly loosen the thumb screw. Push the camera to move left or right until it can stay still horizontally to the ground. Complete this by tightening up the thumb screw. And this is the final move. Unlock the pan axis and start loosening the thumb screw on it. Adjust the pan axis until almost stays horizontally to the ground. Finally, tighten up the thumb screw and we're done. If you're using non-Sony cameras, we're done here. But if you're using Sony cameras, I highly recommend connecting the camera to the gimbal via USB cord. It makes the workflow much easier by giving you ISO, shutter speed and aperture control on the gimbal itself, as well as record button. If the gimbal control didn't function, that's mainly because your camera is set to mass storage. Head up to the camera menu, turn the smartphone control off, and set the USB connectivity to PC control. Turn it on, press and hold, and that's it. And if you're gonna use the same setup in the future, just make sure to take notes of the balancing measurements. That's gonna save you a lot of time. And on this channel, we make gear reviews and photography tutorials. So if you are new here, consider subscribing for more. And if you find this video is helpful, please hit the like button. This is Omar, and see you in another video.